Hey everybody, I'm Charlotte from the Anytype, and if you've seen any of my other tutorial videos, you know that I spend a lot of time in Anytype managing everything from my tasks to my travels and hobbies. Lately though, I've been feeling the limitations of my own setup. I've been spending way too much time either looking for objects I've previously created or deciding where to categorize new objects that I'm in the process of creating. So I decided to give my account a makeover using Tiago Forte's pair method for note-taking and building a second brain. Many Anytype users swear by this method, claiming that it's a low-maintenance framework that can supercharge your productivity by limiting the cognitive burden required to sort and locate your notes. This video is for you if you're a fan of the pair method and looking to implement it in Anytype, or if you're a current Anytype user curious about how this method might impact your productivity. Let's go. To give you an idea of what I'm working with, in my sidebar I've made widgets for each of the key areas that I need to reference in Anytype on a frequent basis. My self-dashboard, a page, is where I've linked all of my rituals and resources that help me maintain my personal well-being. My home dashboard, also a page, includes my meal planning, weekly chores, finances, and a planned renovation project for my kitchen. In summary, it's anything related to managing my household. And my disco room is a collection which I use for personal knowledge management, including my hobbies and interests. Finally, I have a task list pinned here in my sidebar, which is a set of tasks that I check each day and use to prioritize my to-do list. Simply put, the pair method recommends setting up your workspace to include four sections: projects, areas, resources, and archive. When applying this method, each and every note you take should fall into one and only one of these categories. Projects are anything with a goal and a defined due date. Areas are ongoing roles or responsibilities. Resources are useful references that are not immediately actionable. And archive is anything that could fall in the above categories but which is no longer actionable or relevant. To transfer my space to this method, the first thing I did was export my account and all of its objects. I wanted to copy all of my objects over to a new space and begin to sort them, so I created a new account and cleaned it up until there was nothing left except for me and the set of everything. Next, I needed to consider the best way to apply the pair method using the tools available in Anytype. I went through a lot of trial and error here, but eventually I settled on the following. The first three categories, projects, areas, and resources, could be formatted as collections. Collections felt like the most suitable object type because I needed an easy way to add any object, regardless of the type, to one of these categories, similar to the way folders work on your computer. For my archive, on the other hand, I needed a way to tag any object, whether project, area, or focus, as archived and have it automatically filtered into the right place. So I decided to create a set with query archive, which seemed like the most effective way to apply this. In case a project became relevant again, it also gave me the flexibility to remove the tag and restore the project to its right place. Next, I wanted to reformat my space to reflect my new working system. So I deleted the pre-installed widgets from my sidebar and replaced them with the four categories from the pair method. As a last step in my pair setup process, I created new types for projects, areas, and resources in case I needed to change any of my current objects into one of the above. Now that my account was set up, I was ready to get going and dive into the chaos. After importing my previous account into this new space and looking at my set of everything, I could see all of my objects, hundreds of them, in an unsorted list. Now, just looking at this was overwhelming. Mushroom supplements and movies were sitting alongside things like my marketing strategy and my chore list. One thing to keep in mind with Anytype is that there's no strict object hierarchy. Objects aren't nested within each other. Rather, they're connected by links and relations in the graph. This meant that I needed to reconsider how I had organized my information until this point. Essentially, every object I've used to navigate within my graph was either a page, a set, or a collection. Looking at it this way, my main goal was to categorize only my pages, sets, and collections into projects, areas, resources, and archive. To help me do this, I first filtered my list for only objects with type, page, set, or collection. Looking at my pages, I thought it would make sense to begin with those dashboards that I was most familiar with. On my self page, the first objects I saw were my bookmarked workouts and a set which I used to experiment with different health hacks. These seemed like they ought to fall into a specific area, that of health. So I created a new object called health with type area and linked it to my areas collection. From there, I linked the list of pinned workouts and my experiment log to the area health, so when I opened it for my areas collection, I could easily find these objects. After doing so, I no longer needed these linked to my self page, so I deleted them. At the same time that I was linking and resolving these objects, I also added a checkmark relation and filter to my set of objects so that I could keep track of what still needed to be sorted. Now looking at my second column, guided meditations also seemed to be part of my health area, so I simply linked it there. German practice was an area all on its own, so I changed the type to area and linked it anew. And my read it later list of bookmarks felt like a resource more than anything, so I similarly changed the type and filed it to the correct collection. On I went with the rest of the linked objects, changing the types of some of them or creating new areas to encompass them. Once my self page was empty, I could simply delete it as it wasn't useful as a dashboard anymore. Next, looking at my home page, I realized that home was actually an area, and within it, I had an additional area, that of finance. I also had what looked like a project, my kitchen renovation. I simply kept this dashboard, turning it into an area and added it to my areas list, but turned finances into another area of its own. For the kitchen renovation, I changed this into a project and linked it to my projects collection. Now, returning to my list of pages, collections, and sets, I had far fewer unsorted items to work with. Looking at what was left, I applied the same principles, turning some objects into projects, areas, or resources, or creating new projects, areas, and resources to encompass several objects at once. Each project had a target month completion date, which helped remind me of their relative urgency and order them accordingly. Those that were no longer relevant were tagged with archive so they didn't clutter the collections that I was using to manage areas of active interest. It took me a couple of hours, but finally I was able to whittle down my list to zero, with everything having found its own home. The only exception were my tasks, and it was important that I keep these visible in my Anytype workspace as this is my primary task management system. For that reason, I decided to keep my task set and task widget, but restructure my views a bit. Instead of organizing by days of the week, I wanted to organize my tasks according to projects, so I changed everything from Kanban to grid view, cleared out whatever wasn't relevant anymore, and started assigning each task to an associated project or area by adding a relation, linked projects. What was great about this exercise was that it pushed me to evaluate what I was choosing to work on at any given moment. If a task didn't push forward any project or area, did I really need to be doing it at all? Were there invisible projects eating up my time, which I hadn't considered previously? Finally, I added another column with tag today, and a new view searching only for tasks with that tag. Like this, I'm able to view all outstanding tasks for each active project and area, tag which ones I should work on today, and tick off my daily to-do list as I work inside Anytype. Finally, I wanted to clean up the aesthetics of my new para workspace to make things feel as clean and crisp as possible. Of everything in my sidebar, I only really wanted to see active projects and tasks at a given moment, so I changed my areas, resources, and archive widgets to simple links, which I can click into if I need to have a look. Then I decided to change the layout of my three collections from grid view to list view for a more minimal appearance. there really weren't any relations that I needed to see, so the grid view was just cluttering my visual field. I was pretty pleased to have my space feel minimal and clean. So now let's see how the method itself worked out. Now, having tested the pair method for a few days, I wanted to share some observations about how I found this new note-taking system. On the plus side, my work felt much more streamlined. As someone who uses Anytype for drafting notes, managing tasks, and documenting hobbies, it became overwhelming to enter my space and feel bombarded by projects and tasks that were no longer relevant. Furthermore, I was pleased with the way that the structure pushed me to reconsider all of my digital artifacts, from tasks to meditation podcasts. Finally, I loved that I no longer hesitated to add objects that were temporary in nature. Previously, I would struggle to decide whether some temporary objects even belonged in my graph. With the archive system, I'm able to add these objects with peace of mind, knowing that I have a way to process them later. On the flip side, I do find it cumbersome to file away and categorize every new object, making sure it has a home and that it's not duplicated anywhere. In any case, I like to think that it actually saves me time in the long run looking for my objects. Finally, I miss some of the fun details that make my space feel more like me. So in the future, I might reconsider naming some of my objects and widgets to make it feel more unique. So that's my review of using the pair method in Anytype. You can find the link to import my pair structure in your Anytype in the description. If you've ever used pair before or managed to set it up in Anytype yourself, please drop us a comment and let us know how you liked it. Thanks for watching.